There are two types of cities, those that you come back to visit and the rest. We first visited Barcelona back in 2013 for our honeymoon. This was pre-Lifetailored, pre-Brooklyn, and basically before we found ourselves. We remember having an amazing time and thought we had seen and done everything. But this trip, we discovered some amazing new spots and a home away from home that we can't wait to share with you. If you're new to the channel, subscribe to get all of our travel guides and flight hacking tips as they're released. If you want to follow along our journeys, then follow our stories on Instagram at Lifetailored. Barcelona has wonderful food, a great atmosphere, a creative soul. It's only 6 hours from New York, and there's good weather for 8 months of the year. We're not much of museum people, but in Barcelona, it almost feels like a walking museum thanks to the architect Antoni Gaudí. His Sagrada Familia is always within eyesight when you're on a rooftop, and his Casa Balto on the Fifth Ave of Barcelona causes us to stop and take in the wonder every time we walk by. We chose to stay at the Mandarin Oriental Barcelona, and we were so happy. Having never before stayed at a Mandarin Oriental property, and having seen all these celebrities touting why they're a fan, we finally discovered why they're a fan and why now we're also fans for life. From the moment we arrived at Barcelona, the staff couldn't have been more welcoming, accommodating, and friendly. We were greeted with their signature welcome drink, and while we enjoyed the special blend of tea, the team whisked our luggage to our room, and after a quick check-in process, we went upstairs to check out our suite. To say we were blown away was an understatement. The hotel room was designed and furnished like the home of our dreams. It was modern, sleek, and beautiful. Wood blended seamlessly with steel, and the entire suite had every detail nailed. From the built-in refrigerator and the custom cabinets to the massive white ceramic soaking tub in the bathroom to the floor-to-ceiling, windows, and your private outdoor space that had breathtaking views of the city. We only had a weekend in Barcelona, so condensed our gastronomic visits to just a handful of our favorite spots. We started off with Mercado de la Boqueria, which is a great giant food market to taste the best of local ham, cheeses, churros, olive oil, tapas, and wine. For fancy tapas, we headed to Cañete, where we treated to a never-ended assortment of fresh seafood paired with some amazing Spanish wines. Grab a seat at the bar and ask your server for recommendations. We're suckers for hole-in-the-wall authentic spots, so we headed to El Chapinet for tapas. It's named for a type of wine meant to be shared amongst friends. We ordered 2 glasses of cava, the sausage with beans, and of course the Iberico, and the amazing tomato salad. Next to us, there was a couple chatting and flirting in Spanish whom we thought were madly in love, and after a couple of glasses of cava, they started talking to us. And through our broken Spanish, we found out they just got married and both had gotten divorced. So we ordered glasses of cava to celebrate, and upon a better understanding of their Spanish, it turns out that they were not newly married, but in fact getting divorced today, and we're celebrating it. What we love about the city is that only in Barcelona could a couple be having so much fun on their divorce day. To get to Barcelona, of course, we used points. It was 155,000 miles each way for business class, which we transferred from our Chase Ultimate Rewards. If you want to take trip of your dreams using points, we've got a link below. On this trip, we headed to Lake Como next. Check out our playlist at the end of this clip to explore the romance, risotto, and relaxation you can find on that enchanted lake. And if you want to follow along our journeys, then please check out our stories on Instagram at Lifetailored.